Welcome back to the Bob Harden Show. And now here's your host, Bob Harden.
Thanks so much for joining us here on the show. We're providing you news and commentary rooted in the commitment to individual liberty, personal responsibility, limited government, and the rule of law. Coming up, we're going to visit with Seton Motley, the founder and president of Less Government. Right now, we have with us Matthew Germer. He is an election fellow at the R Street Institute. Matt, thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, thanks, Bob. I appreciate the opportunity to be here.
Thank you, Matt. Tell us about the R Street Institute.
Sure. So the R Street Institute is a nonprofit, nonpartisan research organization, and we're really devoted to researching and promoting issues around free markets and limited effective government. And my role in that capacity is to look at elections issues around the country from that lens and to see what we can do to improve choices for voters, as well as ensuring that our elections remain secure and everyone who is eligible to vote has the opportunity to vote.
And everybody who isn't doesn't have that opportunity. So, Matt, I mean, you are doing such important work, and it's so critical. Now, I think here in Florida, we have a pretty darn good election law. I think, you know, we've been kind of an example here for the last few election cycles. But you wrote a column called Florida Republicans Should Stand Up for Voter Freedom, taking issue with some of the changes. Maybe you can tell us about it.
Sure. So I think you pointed out something fantastic, which is that Florida really has become a national leader in elections. Mm-hmm. I know that for many Americans, Florida has been a punchline for the last couple of decades, but that punchline is no longer deserved. At this point, Florida offers their voters pretty substantial choice in how they want to vote. These are rough guidelines, but roughly a third of Florida voters in a normal election, a non, you know, 2020 COVID-19 election, but in a normal election, you'll see a chunk of voters that choose to vote in person on election day, a sizable chunk who choose to vote in person early, and then a chunk of voters who choose to vote by mail.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've been digging in over at R Street around that last piece, which is voting by mail, and taking a look at laws around the country or proposals around the country that might make voting by mail more difficult. And unfortunately, from our perspective, we saw that show up in Florida with a couple of bills that have been put forward. One of them in particular, Senate Bill 90, that would make it a little more difficult to vote by mail by in a couple of ways. And so that's what was the genesis of that article that I put together.
You know what, you really caught my attention because my wife and I vote by mail, enjoy voting by mail. So what are the changes that you think could make it more difficult for us to do that?
Sure. So Senate Bill 90 does a couple of things. First, right now in Florida, if you want to vote by mail, you have to submit a new application to vote by mail every couple of years. It's a little annoying. I think my preference would be, you know, once you sign up to vote by mail, you can remain signed up to vote by mail indefinitely. But this bill would require voters to reapply to vote by mail every single year. And so it wouldn't necessarily change your rights. You'll have the opportunity to do it, but an application to vote by mail every year is honestly just annoying. And similar on that front would be removing drop boxes for voters. And these drop boxes have been a subject of attention around the country. There have been circumstances in other states of drop boxes being placed in counties by partisan actors that aren't necessarily official. We've seen nothing like that in Florida. And if anything, drop boxes really just provide voters another opportunity, another choice about how they want to turn in their ballot, whether they trust the U.S. Postal Service to handle their ballot for them and bring it to the county officials, or if they'd like to bring it to the county officials themselves through the use of a drop box. And so those have been two of the biggest provisions in that bill, making voters re-register to vote by mail every year and removing the ability for a voter to drop off their ballot in a drop box.
Okay, so thank you for that clarification, Matt. And just to get some clarification, you know, I think it's important. We didn't trust the U.S. mail, so we went to a drop box right next to the office of the supervisor of elections. So to me, that's a bad move. Did you mention that we have to register every year by mail in order to renew our opportunity to vote by mail?
That would be the result of the bill if it were to go forward, is annual reapplications for absentee voting by mail.
So what about the concern about voter registration, you know, the roles of voters, and if, you know, does for example, our current law allow, for example, for somebody to die and still be on the rolls and have that vote you know, in some way affected?
So I believe that the way current law is constructed, voter rolls should be checked and updated over time. Mm-hmm. There may be an opportunity to do that process faster, to make sure that if someone passes away in the months just preceding an election, that the voter rolls could be cleaned up perhaps more frequently. But by me, you know, to answer your question generally, yes, the voter rolls are cleaned up from time to time. Mm-hmm. Perhaps it, you know, it would be a question of how quickly that should be done. But the change to the voter rolls and making sure that they are accurate is separate from the question of whether or not folks have signed up to vote by mail.
Yeah, I agree with that. My recall is, and correct me if I'm wrong, is that actually we can register online. Is that incorrect?
I believe that you can.
Yeah. I'm talking about for voting for mail, but you're saying that mm-hmm. this legislation that's proposed would require us to not be able to do it online, but rather have to do it by U.S. mail.
Oh, I apologize if I created that confusion. I don't believe that it would change the mechanism for re-registering, just that it would require you to do it every year.
I understand. Okay, well, thank you for that. So in a perfect world, then, taking a look at Florida, what would you do? What would you like to see us do?
Well, I'd like to really start by complimenting Florida for being a national leader. Mm-hmm. Florida has become a model in how elections should be run. And in large part, rather than tweaking Florida, I would rather see other states adopt the Florida model.
Mm.
I think that, like, as you mentioned, there may always be an opportunity to make changes around the margins to ensure that voter rolls are accurate, to make sure that if there are opportunities where election administration can be cleaned up, little things, I think those are good opportunities, but big sweeping changes that would impact voters and their ability to choose how they want to vote. At this point, I don't see those being necessary in Florida.
All right. Great commentary, Matt. I really appreciate that. R Street Institute, what's the website?
R Street Institute can be found at rstreet.org. That's the letter R and the word street.org.
rstreet.org is the website. Matt, a very informative commentary. Thank you so much for joining us here on the show.
All right. Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure indeed. All right, coming up, we're going to visit with Seton Motley. Seton is the founder and president of Less Government. We're going to do that and more right here in the Bob Harden Show on the Bob Harden Broadcasting Network.
Stay tuned for more of the Bob Harden Show here on the Bob Harden Broadcasting Network.